In this video, I'm going to show you some of the features of GitGuardian Shield, the open source CLI tool to detect secrets from GitGuardian. We're going to go through how to set up a pre-commit hook into this and the different options that are involved with that. And then we're going to take a look at how we can add GitGuardian Shield into our GitHub Actions workflow. But first, let's just take a tiny little bit of time and talk about exactly what is GitGuardian Shield and how it works and the pros and cons associated with adding this. Let's start by looking at exactly how GitGuardian Shield works. Well, GitGuardian Shield leverages the GitGuardian Secrets Detection Engine, and it does this through the GitGuardian API. Now, there's a couple of reasons why we choose to do it this way. Number one, detecting secrets is very complicated. Yes, you can detect high entropy patterns or using regex to find prefixed types of keys, but being able to verify them as true positives and not false positives is quite difficult. You have to include a lot of weak signals, and if possible, you want to be able to verify this against the API provider, verify that the key is in fact valid. And the best way to do this is to leverage the engine behind a powerful commercial tool. The other reason is that secrets detection is constantly evolving. New types of secrets are being issued, and we benefit from the massive amounts of data from GitHub to be able to update the detection patterns. There are, of course, some cons of detecting secrets this way. Number one is that we need an internet connection. We're leveraging an API, so we have to be able to send data externally. But the end result is that you will be able to benefit from more powerful secrets detection than in other tools. But it's first important to understand and weigh up the pros and cons of different tools that are out there. But now we have that out the way, let's dive into what we can do with GitGuardian Shield. All right, let's start by getting our API key that will allow us to be able to send information to the GitGuardian detection engine. So to do this, we need to go to dashboard.gitguardian.com. You can either log in with GitHub or create an account via email. I already have one, so of course, I'm just going to log in. Now, I have no connected repositories to this. This is the GUI, the dashboard that you can connect your GitHub repositories to and scan them via this user interface, but we're going to skip past all of that and go directly down to this button on the bottom that says tab API. Now, down the bottom, we're going to create a new API key. I'm just going to call this test key for video. Okay, so now I'm just going to open up my directory and my terminal. I have here just a repository called Flash Gordon. This is just a standard Python project, nothing special about it. And I'm going to use this as the example for what we're going to do moving forward. So the first thing is I'm going to create a .env file. And this is where I'm going to paste our API key. So we're going to name our API variable git_guardian_API_key equals and what we just copied from the GitGuardian dashboard. One of the great things about GitGuardian Shield is that it's going to search for a .env file automatically to be able to try and find the API key within them. But you can also set this up as an environment variable within your machine, however you would do that normally. But this is the simplest way, so it's the way that I'm going to stick with. So now obviously the next step is we need to install GitGuardian Shield. So I'm just going to quickly navigate to the GitGuardian Shield GitHub repository. Here in our README, if you get stuck, you can find helpful information and examples of code. But what I'm interested in is in the instruction installation guide. And here we can see that it's using pip to install it. So you need to have Python installed to use pip. I'm just going to quickly check that I have pip installed. So I can use the command pip 3. Now the 3 just refers to the version that we're up to at the moment. And obviously, as I do, we're going to run the command pip 3 install GGShield. And that's it, we're good to go. Now that we have GitGuardian Shield installed, we're going to move on to the next step, which is setting up a pre-commit git hook. Now, a pre-commit git hook will prevent any commits from going through if that commit contains a secret. Now, it's really important to know that if a secret makes it into your Git repository, it needs to be considered compromised. A pre-commit hook prevents them getting there in the first place. Therefore, the cost of remediation is nearly none. Now that we have GitGuardian Shield installed and our API key in a .env file, we can navigate over to the GitHub GGShield repository, scroll down to install command, and we'll see that we have some options for installing a pre-commit hook. Now, the first option we need to decide on is whether or not we want to install a pre-commit hook locally or globally. The difference is that local means it's going to be installed on the repository that you're navigated within, so just a singular repository, and globally means it's going to be installed throughout all of your repositories. We can very quickly see what this looks like. If I navigate into my directory and I open up the hidden folder here, .git, and go into hooks, you'll see that some example git hooks that are in there. Now, if I run the command ggshield install m for mode and local, you'll see it successfully installed a pre-commit hook, and we can see that here. This is the pre-commit hook that's going to be run. Now, if I delete this, and I instead run the command ggshield install -m global, you'll see that it hasn't added anything into this folder. And that is because if I navigate into the root directory of my computer, of my machine, you'll see another .git folder that's hidden here, with again a folder that says hooks inside it. And here we see the pre-commit hook. So this is where the global pre-commit hook lives, as compared to the local pre-commit. So now we have everything installed. Let's check to see if it works as expected. So I'm going to open up a file called Python server. And this is going to open up just an example Python server file. And in here, we can see a variable contributed slack key. So at the moment, this has a placeholder, but we're going to remove this and put in an example slack key. Now, this isn't a real key, but it's close enough to trigger our detection engine. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add this into a commit. So git add Python y, and then we're going to commit this. And you'll immediately see that we get a report in our console. It says here that it's detected a Slack user token, and it's told us that this is on line 10, and it's to change between this and this. And as we can confirm, yeah, on line 10, we have our Slack token. So we can see that our pre-commit hook is working. But if this secret is false, or we want to live dangerously and just commit it into our repository anyway, well, we can ignore this. With a simple command, ggshield ignore, last found. Now, what this command does is it actually creates a YAML file within our repository. We can see right here, .gitguardian.yaml. Now, if I open this up, you can see here, this is not actually our secret, it's our SHA token. But this means that in the future, GitGuardian is going to ignore this particular Slack key. So now, if I want to commit this, we can see that this has been committed fine, and I can then push this into my repository where I now have a Slack token. And there we have it. That is how to install a pre-commit hook in GitGuardian. Now, next, we're going to use GitGuardian Shield to be able to set up a GitHub action or GitHub action workflow to scan our secrets on push. So to do this, we can either navigate to GitHub itself and do it within the repository interface by clicking on Actions and set up new workflow. But in this case, we're going to do it just on our local machine here. So first, we need to create a new directory called .github. Then we need to create a directory inside this called workflows. And finally, I'm just going to create a file called main.yaml. And we can open up this. Now, if we navigate back over to the GGShield repository in GitHub, and we go down to GitHub Actions, you can see that there is already the code needed to be able to set up this action. So we're just going to copy this and go back, paste this into our main.yaml. So now we're going to push these changes into our repositories, which will update our actions workflow automatically. So now that we can see, we have this folder .github/workflows and our main.yaml file is within there. And if we go over to actions, we can see here that it's already added in this action, but we have an error here. So if we click on this and look at where this has failed, we see this message, error, GitGuardian API key is needed. Now, obviously we don't want to push our .env file we've created into our Git repository. There's a much more secure way to handle secrets within GitHub. So if we navigate over to settings, go down to secrets. Here, we can create a new repository secret. So, GitGuardian, and the value is the same API key we used before. Go ahead and add that secret. Now, if we go back to our code, we can check to see that this GitHub action is working. So now what you'll remember is that we added the secret to our GitGuardian ignore file by ignoring the last one, but we're only ignoring it locally. So that means that if I have GitHub Actions installed, it's like another layer of defense to ensure that the secrets get picked up. So let's go ahead and push this and see what happens. So git add git commit. Okay, so now we've pushed this file with an active secret into our Git repository. And if we go into here and we click over to actions, we'll see that we're running an action on the commit we just made, updating server. So let's go ahead and wait for this to finish, which should take about a few seconds. Now, what we can see now that it's finished running is that we get another error here. So if we click onto this, click on GitGuardian scan, we can see that it's failed here, but this time it hasn't failed because of the API key, it's failed because of the Slack user token. So we can see this here, and we get basically the exact same response. Now, obviously, if you're the owner of the repository, at this point, you now can take action. You can decline the merge request if it's one. You can see that it's failed, so you know that something's wrong. But the next question you might be asking is that, well, if we ignore this file locally in our pre-commit hook, then we obviously want to ignore it in our GitHub workflows. And yes, that's probably correct. This was just for a demonstration. And all we need to do to ignore this in our GitHub Actions workflow check as well is just to add in that GitGuardian YAML file that contains the ignore shard. So we're going to do that right now. I'm going to go git add dot gitguardian dot yaml And we're going to push this into our repository as well. Now, if we push the same file again, so we make an arbitrary edit, resave this file, and now make another adjustment, git add python server.py git commit and we push this into our remote repository. We can now go back to our GitHub Actions. We can see here that when we updated the ignore file, the check run went through smooth. And because I've updated the ignore file for GitGuardian, we shouldn't get an error on this check run as well, but let's find out. And as you can see, this here has passed no problems because that secret is now in our ignore file. And there we have it. That's how you can add GitGuardian Shield into your GitHub Actions workflow.